Hello, this is K1, and this is Space Station K1. New and improved here on Kerbal Space Program. And for this, we are going to get our truss core expansion attached to the station. For that, I will turn to the KTS Enterprise already in orbit here. And there she is. Should already be on fairly close rendezvous approach to our station. So let's go ahead and burn our engines to polish that off. Station is about 2.6 kilometers away as we take a quick peek into the payload bay. Let's see, our two modules that we are going to attach. First is the central truss that will connect to the battery module, as well as a second that we will attach to it to expand it outward in both directions. And an upgraded escape vehicle airlock module here that actually has some docking struts to keep it more stable. So as the station begins to move in an odd direction, let's make sure we match that direction. A slight glitch indicates that we are now seeing the station visually. Turn that off. We can barely make out its structure. We can take care of the rest with thrusters. We don't want to use up or engine propellant if necessary. Shuttles aren't really designed for travel. And as we make our final approach, we are 2.2 kilometers out. Let's give ourselves a little kick in the rear to get us there faster. Meters per second, we can speed up time for the journey. And as we orbit, we kind of slip off to the side. It's kind of how orbital paths work sometimes. Come on, center us out here. What's our encounter? Point two. Point one. Point zero. That's what we want. Let's begin a braking maneuver here. Got 7 meters per second to kill. And we are approaching from the wrong side of the structure, unfortunately. But that's okay. I built this shuttle with thruster propellant to spare. We made our successful rendezvous. Start turning into position here. Actually, I may need to face the other direction. And lined up, and down we go. Or, well, down with relation to the orientation of my shuttle. Sometimes maneuvering in space takes a long time and involves a lot of waiting. Can't exactly do Top Gun in space, can we? In the meantime, get some lights on and open our docking collar. Oh boy, that really shines on the station, doesn't it? Not really supposed to happen that way. Just turn on that light and that light. I think it's the wheel lights that caused that. But since the second shuttle landed successfully at night, I was very glad to have those lights. Next time I may forego the shuttle docking procedure entirely. I'm sure we've seen it enough times already. Well, let's try chase camera. Yeah, it should be fairly lined up. With the shuttle between the sun and the station, kind of puts us in darkness. We might as well be docking at night. I'm not even sure how well you can see it until the station starts drifting into the shuttle's lights. or if it ever actually does. Getting good. Still fairly close front to back. Side to side, we're about dead on. Drifting a little. Front to back, still looking good. And I think we got it. Turn SAS off for now. As the shuttle and the station latch together. While the sun is right there. Well, that's what lights are for. Actually, that's what Kerbals are for. I should bring one of my crewmen out to finish this process here, which is exactly what I'm going to do. Let's call on Bob. Okay, Bob, time to whip out that old ratchet. And link the struts to the shuttle. His head was in the way. There it goes. And shuttle is now safely docked to the station. Now our first goal here should be to Well, Which one first? I'll do the easiest one first. Well, actually, no, they're both difficult. Okay. You take this airlock module and replace it over there. So, plenty of propellant on board our escape vehicle. I think it actually needs a pilot now. So I'm going to transfer Percy to the escape module. That gets some distance. Let's make sure this one has some propellant. Come on, there we go. Undock. One light should be all we need. Let's grab it. Off target, but it'll settle. Alrighty. Little tight fit, but it'll do. Thank you. Okay, we really need some sunlight here. Turn that light on and that light off. Oh, we actually are on the night side. Oh goodness. Been spending so long taking a rendezvous that we didn't realize the sun passed over us. Or I say we. Of course I mean me. Might be people watching going, "Dude, the sun is setting!" Sorry, I was focused on my objective. Cutting velocity. Let's get this thing connected without much benefit of eyesight. I can make it out. I'm not sure how well it's visible on video, but latch it does. Let's turn all our lights on now. Drift too far away. While we move Bill over to the airlock. Oops. Where he will exit the spacecraft and perform a little construction. There are four docking nodes to work with here. One. Okay, well, this big head is in the way. Come on. Sure how I'm still obstructing it. Warp that link up. Let's try this way. Link to you. Still obstructed. How am I obstructing you? Well then, let's try it manually then. See if we can do this remotely. link. There we go. Apparently, Bob has a big head. It is not good to be big-headed in the space program. It is from far away. Come on. And link you here. There we go. Well, we've got stability taken care of, so that's a good thing. Let's get you back to the station. Okay, I'm going to have to deposit this old airlock node on another docking port temporarily. Okie doke. Stop. I appear to be missing a thruster quad here. Don't hit the shuttle. Am I going to be able to? You know what? Well, we'll have our first piece of space junk. It's become a little too difficult a task to dock this old useless thing. So we'll give it some distance and then let it fly. Give a little bit of speed. And then let it go. Darn it. Automatic thrusters never seem to want to work the way I want them to. Okay, about how far am I? I'm closing. So let's go ahead and get our construction node out of here. And since its only node is too small for anything else but the thing we got rid of, I'm going to add space junk number 2. We'll let you fly. And return to the station. Now, which module will be back first? I think the manned one is the most important. So, let's get you docked. Whoa, this thing is not really maneuverable, like, is it? Well, it's not really made for much else than getting crew home. Hopefully it won't have to do much else after that. Come on, lock into place. There it goes. Phew. I think this is going to be the last time I use that little vehicle for anything. This one, however, is a bit more reliable. So the big objective is to get the truss module right where that battery module is. And since the battery module has to connect to it anyway, I will kill two birds with one stone. Or in this case, two modules with one approach. Watch the tail. And now that that's docked, I'm gonna wait for sunlight. I've had it with doing things in the dark. It's a little frustrating. Not that it helps us much, because we're still obstructed by the shuttle's fat belly here. But that's okay. So we're gonna have to disconnect these. Let me guess, they're all connected on the other side. Yep, okay. Now, with the strut, or the truss, the way it is, I'm going to want the panels along its form. Okay. Because eventually I'm going to have larger panels on the truss going along the length, so I'm going to want some panels going the other direction. Tilt into proper orientation. And now make our approach. This is going to be another tight fit again. I'm going to start putting the big modules in the back end instead of the front. In fact, I'm going to have to for any further truss expansion. Dead on here. And kerclunk. Now, now, theoretically, I could just pull it back and turn it, but it's facing the wrong way. So I'm going to have to rotate it without hitting the shuttle. If I had a second payload assist module, that would be nice, but I do not. Be a waste of the space program's resources. Are we clear of the shuttle? Yes, we are. Almost. Okay. Center of mass was about there. So that's where I'm going to cut it. Wrong way. This way. Looks like I'm turning a wrench or something. All right. Straighten you out. Are we vertical relative to the station? We actually are. That's pretty good. All right. Time to latch that on without the benefit of a targeting computer. and bring it on in. You know, I could just redock that to the end here, but then I would lose stabilization control and this thing would start tumbling. You never had a headache in Kerbal Space Program until you tried to recover a module that was tumbling. Right, lined up vertically. That way. I think I'm lined up. I don't know how a B-wing pilot must feel. Looking good. Looking good. Looking good. Looking good. Looking good. Looking good. I'm bringing on in there. Curse snap. And there we are. The first truss is attached with the sun in the wrong place here. I'm going to go ahead and detach our shuttle so we can get a better vantage point on what we're dealing with here. And this shuttle is not bringing anything home. We can close our payload bay. And let the sun see our station. Okie dokie. Station time. In the sunlight. And the shuttle backs away. So, what we've got here is the elongated shape of our main station complex, all of the manned parts. And then attached on this side here, where there are no ladders, the central truss will have a battery module on either end, and then we'll continue out up and down from this vantage point, with extended trusses that have larger solar panel arrays and other equipment that will form the continued basis of our station. There's a lot of docking struts to connect here, but I'm not going to bog down the program by connecting all of those. So from here we shall leave Space Station K1. Let's get that panel extended. That one shall remain out, as will the second battery module when it's connected. And this has been the truss expansion to Space Station K1. Thank you very much for joining me, and see you all next time.